Hello friends, today we are going to talk about substrate inhibition. So what is substrate inhibition? Substrate inhibition is a phenomena in which substrate itself is going to inhibit the reaction. Okay, the increase in concentration of substrate beyond a level is going to inhibit the reaction. So which means that if we see this graph between the velocity of the reaction and the substrate concentration, we find that an increase in the substrate concentration, first there is an increase in the velocity of the reaction. Okay, so with increase in the substrate concentration, at first there is an increase in the reaction velocity, but after certain substrate concentration is achieved, if we further increase the substrate concentration, the velocity of reaction is going to decrease or even become zero. So if you see here, this is the substrate concentration at which the velocity of reaction is maximum, but if you increase the substrate concentration beyond that particular level, the velocity of reaction is going to decrease or even become zero. And this phenomena is known as substrate inhibition. When the concentration of substrate, when the increase in the concentration of substrate beyond a level causes inhibition of the reaction. And we'll see how this happens. For that, we first need to understand what is uncompetitive inhibition. Okay, so uncompetitive inhibition is an inhibition where there is no competition between substrate and the inhibitor. Okay, there is no competition between the substrate and inhibitor to bind to the enzyme. So for example, this is the enzyme and it has two sites. The first site is for substrate and this site is for inhibitor. The substrate binds to the enzyme and forms enzyme-substrate complex. So if there is no inhibitor present, this enzyme-substrate complex would end up forming a product and a vacant enzyme. But if there is a inhibitor presence in the vicinity, in the surrounding, this inhibitor is going to bind to its own site, to the inhibitor site over the enzyme, and now at this stage the reaction is arrested, which means that now the reaction is not going to proceed further, and this is known as uncompetitive inhibition. So where there are two sites, one site is for inhibitor, another site is for substrate. Substrate binds to the enzyme and forms enzyme substrate complex, and in the presence of inhibitor, this enzyme substrate complex inhibitor binds to this enzyme substrate complex and the reaction is arrested. The reaction does not proceed. But there is a different version of this uncompetitive inhibition in which the site for the substrate and the site for inhibitor are similar. So here if you see, this is an enzyme and the site for substrate, this site for substrate and this site for inhibitor are very similar. The only difference is the site for substrate is having very high affinity for the substrate and the site for inhibitor is having very low affinity for the substrate, which means that substrate can bind to the site of the inhibitor. The substrate in this case can bind to the site of the inhibitor, but it has very low affinity, which means that if the concentration of substrate is well below this level, then the enzyme is only going to bind to the substrate and form enzyme-substrate complex. So there will be formation of enzyme-substrate complex, and after that there will be formation of product. But if the concentration of substrate is beyond this level, then there will be a huge amount of substrate in the vicinity of the enzyme. The enzyme will form enzyme-substrate complex, but still the substrate will bind to the inhibitor site. Okay, so the enzyme is going to form enzyme substrate complex, but because of so much substrate present in the vicinity of the enzyme, even the substrate would even bind to this site, which is actually the site of inhibitor. So the substrate binds to the site of inhibitor because there is an excess of substrate and the site for substrate and inhibitor are similar. Okay, so this is known as substrate inhibition, when substrate itself binds to the site of the inhibitor on the enzyme. So what is the important point to note here? The important point to note here is that substrate inhibition happens when the site for inhibitor and the site for substrate over the enzyme are similar. So which means that binding site of substrate and inhibitor are similar. So this is only going to happen when the binding site of substrate and inhibitor are similar. Okay, but still the site for substrate is having high affinity for substrate, but because of the excess amount of substrate that is present in the surrounding, substrate also binds with the inhibitor site. So the second point is high concentration of substrate. So this substrate inhibition is only going to happen when there is high concentration of substrate. So it is only going to happen when there is high concentration of substrate. So this was all about substrate inhibition. If you have any questions or queries or suggestions, please do mention them in comments. Thanks.